Yeah, I got involved in the graffiti scene back in Australia in approximately 1988, but I was really started writing about 89 and doing a lot of stuff, 89, 1990. You know, as a 15, 16 year old kid doing graffiti, paint on the train lines, illegally, most nights. That's how I, and then I kind of, down the track I went to art school, and I sort of, then I was doing a lot of like workshops, like teaching kids how to, running like workshops for kids into graffiti, and I was also doing mural commissions. And then the whole street art movement took off later on. So that kind of gave me the whole knowledge of the spray can, and then I also had an interest in like traditional painting, like kind of figurative painting. So really, what I'm doing now is it's kind of a mix, a blend of those two backgrounds, graffiti and or traditional painting. But I did develop a technique that I kind of became, I don't know, I'd call it unique. You know, to me it was my style, which was some people call it pointillism. I make the image out of dots, but it's actually drips. So it's individual drips, and so that's my style. I call them drip paintings, but that's like that wall there, or so dots made out of drip. When this whole kind of street art movement took off, approximately around the year 2000. I think a lot of people were kind of skeptical of it, were thinking it was kind of a fad that was going to come and go, and a lot of people still believe that. You know, I know street artists that go, street art, it's finished, it's dead. But at the same time, the street artists who say, no, it's only just beginning. So you know, it depends which way you look at it. Mainstream, because you know it's marketing companies, they're looking for what's cool all the time on the street, so they go, yeah, we want a piece of that, you know. So it's really up to the artist how they deal with it. Either they've got to keep it on the edge, or they become a product. And once again, there's two points of view, whether that's right or wrong. Whether, you know, it's like you could say, street artist, okay, it's my art, I should treat it as a product and get what I can out of it. And others are sort of, I'm not kind of that way. I prefer to keep removed from that and just completely do my own thing. I chose to live here because of, I liked what was going on the streets, in the art. And also for me, it's like it's Europe, you know. When you come from Australia, it's like, you know, Europe is, it's quite small. So, it's, you know, for me to be in London and then, like, tomorrow I'm going to Berlin to paint.